Piracy is a massive part of today's online culture. 24% of all global internet bandwidth is used for online piracy every year, which may not sound like a lot, but on average, global internet usage is at about 900 terabytes every second as of 2023. That means every second, 216 terabytes of data is used for piracy. While pirating games might only take a fraction of that number, and the rest is filled with users pirating movies, TV shows, and pornography, games are still one of the most pirated types of content globally. Just on Reddit alone, the r/piratesub has over 350,000 users. The communities found on Discord and the web can also have massive communities of users that are active daily. Okay, great. Gaming Piracy has a large community of users and lots of people pirate games, so what's the problem? Reminder, this is not a video on the ethics of piracy or a guide on how to pirate. This is just an overview of what I have done for the piracy community so far. Please stay safe on the internet and support the games you play. The problem is where people are getting their games. For pirates new and old, finding content is the whole battle when pirating. The first half of this problem is that users who pirate games are 4 times more likely to get malware or virus on their PC, if they even detect it, compared to users who pirate movies or TV shows. This is a huge problem for users who may be uneducated about the dangers of pirating or unaware of safe places to download games from. The other half of the problem is that finding safe sites is hard. If you were to Google Cyberpunk 2077 download, you would get normal links, such as Steam, Epic Games, and GOG. But we are pirating and we don't want to pay for the game, so we Google Cyberpunk 2077 cracked download, and you start finding download links. You find YouTube videos, links to crack sites such as Skid Row Codex Cracks.com, IGGGames.com, or even an alert from Google saying that they have removed links due to complaints under the US DMCA. Many users fall for these traps of unsafe downloads and get major consequences from it, such as a virus, old game version, or the game straight up not launching or playing. I too am a pirate and found myself on these very same sites, getting viruses and trying to troubleshoot a game that was literally just 60 gigabytes of vapor. Many users do the exact same and it's a problem. There are subreddits such as r/piracy with mega threats about the good places to pirate from for all different types of content. And for most people that is good enough, but the content is very general and usually the mega thread isn't updated regularly or the content isn't really meant for games. So now we know the problem, but how did I fix it? It all started on a piracy discussion Discord server where I had been a member for roughly 6 months. The server offered bounties for developers to create things that would be beneficial to the users of the server while offering a good sum for completing and releasing the tool asked of the bounty. One day there was a bounty posted for a Discord bot that would search popular direct download or DDL sites for games and give you direct links. At the time I wasn't a developer, but I had watched many Python videos and game dev vlogs, and I thought this might be a good opportunity to make some money while learning to code. I took up the bounty and got to work. Watching tutorials and copy-pasting code was the main way of development, and it took me pretty far. I learned web scraping with tools such as Beautiful Soup and Selenium, and with the help of another user in the Discord server, we created something great at the time, even though it barely worked, but I was proud of it and got paid. When asked for a name of the project, I decided to call it Rezi. After that release, I took a break from coding and moved on. Fast forward a couple months, and in my senior year of high school, I took a basic programming class with Python and got permission from the teacher to be able to work on my own things. So I started learning web development. I got really into it and tried to think of a project, and I decided to revisit Rezi. My first iteration of the project was released on January 29th, 2022, and only included about 3 sites and put the entire list of links in plain text on the site with some cool color. A lot of people loved it, and it worked really well as long as you waited 30 seconds for the entire page to load. Unfortunately, I don't have the source code anymore, but you can view all the iterations of the Rezi website on the Wayback Machine. Then, about a month later, I introduced MeleeSearch into the project and got a real search engine going. This was a huge development, and it even sported some really cool lightning animations. The project got very popular, and I continued adding more and more sites. The site looked and acted the same way until about 3 months ago, in October 2022, I decided to completely rewrite everything. Up to this point, everything had been scraped using Selenium, and the website was done in plain HTML and CSS, with a little bit of JavaScript for the Mealy Search Edition. Now, I was very capable in Python and React.js now that I had released other projects such as Mozzie, Apocto, and Leecher's Paradise. I felt that compared to those sites, Rezi was my flagship and had been lagging behind in design and performance. So, I rewrote the scraper using Scrapy and rewrote the front end using React. And what we have today is the result, a website with over 80 hand-selected and safe sources to download literally any game imaginable. It sports a clean new design that is minimalistic and easy for users who may even be on mobile, a robust search thanks to Mealy Search, and even an in-browser emulation for supported systems such as NES, SNES, Game Boy, DS, Arcade, and even Nintendo 64. So recently, I made the last and final updates to Rezi, and after exactly 2 years, I committed the final changes to the repo and stood back to admire my work. This website is a resource that has given so many pirates a safe and accessible way to download games they want quickly and safely, so that even a swabby could figure it out. I have finally solved the biggest problem of gaming piracy.